It's 11 a.m. on a Tuesday in February in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Behind the city's Van Andel Arena, a bus is being loaded. The arena is home to the American Hockey League's Grand Rapids Griffins, primary affiliate to the National Hockey League's Detroit Red Wings. Through the years, the Griffins have seen over 120 players graduate from their roster to a role in the NHL. Among them are names like NHL All-Star goalie Jimmy Howard, Red Wings defenseman Nicholas Cronwall, and forward Valtteri Filppula. Today, the Griffins are making the short trip to Grand Rapids' closest rivals, the Chicago Wolves. They may be leaving home ice, but few of them call Grand Rapids home. Like many professional hockey teams, the Griffins are a fusion of global talent featuring players like forward Gustav Nyquist from Halmstad, Sweden, and top prospect Brendan Smith from Mimico, Ontario. Others hail from places like Quebec, South Africa, Alaska, or in the case of NHL veteran Chris Connor, his hometown of Livonia, Michigan is only a short 2.5-hour drive on Interstate 96. Players settle in and claim their seats, some of them doubling up for space.
Oh, hello. Best of seven.
No, we already said that. Get in there.
Where each player calls home is explored via matching trivia in the team's magazine, Graffiti, which members of the team take it upon themselves to solve.
Just a bunch of questions.
Yeah, just questions, and then you got to match the guy's city to the question.
Its name means abundant with wild pigeons. Anybody.
I'm feeling like the pigeons one. He's got to do something with Joey Mac. I don't know why.
It seems like we're the only BC boys, aren't we?
Right here, BC.
Oh, is there a lot of gold mined in South Africa?
Yeah.
Oh! Its post office has the only chimney in the world with a window.
What?
Put you there, because I think it probably is.
Piche. Rena Narenda.
Hosts the second largest barbecue rib festival in North America.
Oh, that's gotta be south somewhere.
Yeah, Cali. Maybe.
That's Cali. It could be.
No,
that's not really a Cali thing.
Oh,
no, I don't know. That's what I'm saying.
These are stupid.
While some members of the team take the time to relax, others jockey for seats to play cards.
Oh, we gotta figure out who's
here. Credit card.
I didn't bring my wallet.
It's a red one to me.
Yeah. It's Gus. I didn't bring my wallet.
Hey, pick a card under. Can't see.
Gloss.
Land the crazy hands.
Oh!
He takes it.
Zedekalius.
Sir, one more out first.
I knew it.
I don't have a heart.
Don't play anything.
Your lowest cards.
Thanks.
Well, can we play?
Yeah.
Time expired, you're done.
Time expired.
While intense, this may prove to be the least physical competition for the next 24 hours. The real test is still a few toll booths away in Chicago. After arriving at the team's hotel, members of the Griffins continue their card game before heading to dinner. For the Griffins, coaches and staff, they choose to spend time at a nearby sports bar to check on the Detroit Red Wings as they embark on a record-setting home winning streak.
Grand Rapids. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. We're here at the rink. My buddy Skinny's taking care of everything.
The morning skate not only gives a chance for the players to fine-tune any game plans, but also for them to take a look at their opponents, though the term is used loosely. It's not uncommon in professional sports to find yourself one day playing against the team that brought you up, rendering your former friends and roommates as new rivals. Griffins captain Garnett Exelby is very familiar with this transition.
Yeah, I was very fortunate to play here and play quite a bit, and we won a championship my first year in Chicago, and then that sort of gave me a wealth of experience going into my second year pro, and I think I sort of hit the ground running a little bit in the second year and got a great opportunity when Bob Hartley came into Atlanta and he was looking for a player just like me to make the team a little grittier in Atlanta, so I got a great opportunity there and tried to make it last as long as I could.
Following the practice, many players return to the hotel to eat a lunch and rest their bodies before the punishment they are sure to endure.
And we are live at the Allstate Arena in Chicago, Illinois, where tonight your Grand Rapids Griffins take on the Wolves in a rare road game in the month of February, and the great rivalry renewed between the Griffins and the Wolves here in the Windy City.
Despite Grand Rapids and Chicago being in different divisions, games between the two teams lend themselves to be physical. Tonight is no different. Following the Griffins taking their early lead with a power play goal, forward Mitch Callahan is called for slashing. And the game officials make sure their call is clear and unprotested.
No. He got pushed in.
What? Are you fucking kidding me, buddy?
Sit down right here. 15 spot the slash. Sit down.
This man?
Anybody else want to sit down?
Luckily, nothing comes from the Griffins being shorthanded. Though their momentum comes to a grinding halt as the Wolves strike twice in less than a minute. Sending the Griffins to their locker room with a bitter taste in their mouths.
It was good, but I have to be, but I can't block the guy.
Oh, no, don't block the
Don't
guy.
Block it, just go there, yeah?
We're all over him here, boys.
Thank you.
team returns to the ice, but just 83 seconds into the middle period, Chicago finds a hole in Jordan Pierce. Causing coach Kurt Fraser to turn to backup goalie Tom McCullum. The goaltending change seems to be just what Grand Rapids needs. But it would all be for naught if they can't break the Wolves' net-minding counterpart, Eddie Lack. Shot after shot becomes save after save, and with every passing minute, the deficit seems to grow. The Griffins' hard work finally pays off with 9 minutes left when Joachim Andersen bangs home a rebound off a shot by Chris Menard, drawing the visitors within one shot of tying the game.
Rebound of the backhand shot by Menard, who's got another point, 8 of them in the last 2-plus games.
And halfway into the third period, Brendan Smith gives the team exactly what they're looking for.
One-timer score! Brendan Smith ring it off the goal post and in!
With the end of regulation and the beginning of overtime, each team is assured 1 point. But with a second point at stake, this compromise does nothing to ease the tension and intensity between either side. But sometimes, intention and intensity don't win games.
Now Chicago with a puck and here's the speedy Bill Sweat. He's around the defense, shot score. Just like that, 18 seconds in, the Wolves win it, 4-3.
It's 11:02 p.m. This may be the end of the road trip for the team, but it's far from the end of their journey. For many, it's another tryout. An opportunity to hone their skills. A chance to prove oneself. The result may sting, but with each mistake and misstep they make, they are learning and waiting for a chance to voyage further from home. To make another stop and another step on their road trip to the National Hockey League.